Upton Park on a fine afternoon. We're going to see West Ham United, the top scorers in the first division of the Football League, but a team smarting under a 4-0 defeat on Wednesday in the first leg of the League Cup semi-final. So they've made four big changes. Burnett, Burkett, Brown and Byrne have been dropped from the West Ham United side. And a lot of the fans are welcoming back number 9, Deer, to lead the attack. And Martin Peters, number 4, will of course be one of the key men in midfield. Sheffield Wednesday, not quite such prolific scorers, but they start their quest to try and get to Wembley for the second season in succession next week when they play Queen's Park Rangers. They are without John Ritchie, their tall number 9, but McCalliog, number 8, is their great midfield schemer. He did so much for them in their cup run last season and could well do it again this season. The referee, Mr. C.H. Nichols from Plymouth, and it's Sheffield Wednesday who are wearing white shirts to kick off. Sitting just behind me is the Sheffield Wednesday chairman, the new chairman of the Football Association, Dr. Stephen. Good to see back in the Sheffield team. Mick Mobley, who missed last season's cup final because of an injury he sustained in the semi-final. Nasty, tricky crosswind, which make things rather difficult for the players. Four. Here comes Hurst, West Ham's top scorer, to Sissons. Dear, back to Sissons. Nichols to Peters. Seely. Sissons. West Ham crowding a wee bit too much then. As Peters. And this is young Sissons. There's number 11. Pickles to Peters. Raybrook being forced back. Oh, a lovely bit of football. That is how deep Eustace is playing. You see, he's a midfield player. Once again demonstrating that numbers on the players' backs mean absolutely nothing. Away come Wednesday once again. Due to Ford. Clever bit of work there by Quinn to jump over the ball. Number 10 Ford, the man who shot. Number 9 Quinn, unsighted standard. Young, but a small forward line Wednesday's, but moving well. 5 minutes gone, no score. Free kick to West Ham. Pugh putting his foot up too high. It's catching Seely on the eyebrow. Moore with the free kick. Deer. Sisters Deer away down the left. Now here comes Ford again. Branford free on the right. Branford is number 2. Four. And away comes Moore for West Ham. McCallio. And and Eustace coming up on his right. Wednesday moving very well at the moment. Hugh, Branford again breaking on the right. Covering by Bexton. Quinn to McCallion. Hugh and Eustace. Wednesday moving so well, passing the ball accurately. To Charles. Young forward to Pugh. Defensive players not afraid to take on a man either. McCallion. And another corner to Sheffield Wednesday. There's Graham Pugh, one of the many fine youngsters on the Sheffield Wednesday books, taking all the corners. Eustace. There's Eustace, number 11. Hurst. Maybe a shot from Hurst. That was the shot of the match so far. That's the sort of shooting power that made Jeff Hurst the hat-trick star of the World Cup final. Two of the West Ham backs going into a Wednesday player, going into Ford, Bovington, Charles, free kick to Wednesday. Ellis to Bexton. Rather untypical of Bexton. Moore with the free kick. Goal kick to Sheffield Wednesday. Many people thought they would be concentrating on defence in this match, but they certainly haven't done. Free kick to Sheffield Wednesday. 10 minutes from half time. Number 10, Ford. Hurst assistance. Branford chasing back. What a bad ball to Hurst. Dead on the right wing. Dear. Burst into an error. Charles to Moore. Peters. Martin Peters. Always a dangerous player, anywhere within 30 yards of the goal. Seeley. A good throw to Braybrook. Great save by Springett. Braybrook. Mistakes being made in this match, but it isn't surprising when you look at the playing surface, and when you look at the effects of this wind, just look at the paper which is swirling around all over the place. There's not much you can do when the ball refuses to travel through the mud. Beautifully taken by Deer. Perhaps a shot from him. Hit them so hard that you knock the goalkeeper over, that's something. Hugh to Eustace. Quinn to McCallum. And Moore is penalised. Farling, number 8, McCallum. 5 minutes before half-time, Brantford to take the free kick for Sheffield Wednesday, and rain clouds coming over. It's beginning to rain now. Peters, Sissons, Greenwood, and Springett. Well, the excitement really hotting up now. Away goes Pugh for Sheffield Wednesday. Quinn on the left wing. That was a foul by Moore. Quinn. And to take the free kick is Pugh. West Ham have got 9 men back. Sissons. That was a bad one, and now Young for Sheffield Wednesday. That's what I call generous. You give him the ball by Sissons, so you give it back to him. No play on. Linesman watching that carefully. All the ball must be over the line. Dear to Sissons, number 11. Seeley to Brim. You get the ball by Hurst. It's an appeal for offside, but it's a goal. No, it's no goal. The linesman's got his flag up. Good decision, offside, I would think. Offside. I think there was little doubt that he was offside then. There weren't two defenders between him and the goal when the ball was last played. referee, even though lights were flagging for more handling offence. Bobbington rather late with that tackle. Free kick to Wednesday. This should well be the last act of the first half. Next. Corner kick. Number 8, McCallum. Now the West Ham come back to pack their penalty area. Second stick away and time is not added on for corner kicks to be taken. And I think the whistle is going to go before the kick is taken. Yes, the whistle goes. It's no time to take the corner. It is half-time. An interesting first half, which West Ham was slow to start. No score. Under difficult conditions, a good first half. There's a section of the 29,250 crowd as West Ham United start the second half. An interesting enough game so far. Sheffield Wednesday promising a lot, not quite getting there with their finish up front. West Ham starting slowly but coming into it more as the first half wore on. Sealing. Best. Bravery. Useless. That was just about a couple of feet away from being a good pass. Sheffield Wednesday. And Quinn was held in by Moore. Number 3, Mixon. Sheffield Wednesday captain. Attackers, most of them are small. As somebody said the other day, Dixie Dean wasn't all that tall, but what a great header of the ball he was. Eustace, Pugh going on the left wing. There's Pugh. Hit pretty hard across the goal. They haven't tried that yet. Dear across to Sealy. Took that one the extra yard, which was fatal. Really, it's ding dong stuff. One side has a go, and then the other side comes on the attack. This time it's Wednesday with Pugh. Ford. To hit them better than that. Ford will have to hit them better than that to beat Stanton. More to Hurst. Ouch, that's a bad one. That's Quinn. It's 3-3 for Wednesday. Oh, that's not counting a great goalkeeper like Stanton. Long up to Ford. respite from Eustace. 15 minutes of the second half gone. No score. I think the conditions are beginning to tell on the players. It's a bit hard going now. One or two of them puffing and blowing a bit. Quinn. Well, Calliope to Quinn. Neat football by Wednesday. Up to four. It's Young. 10 forward. Charles there again for West Ham. Deer up to Hurst. Both teams putting the pace on a bit now. It is going some under these conditions. Ceiling. Oh, he telegraphed that one. Still went to corner. Seeley going to take the corner for West Ham. Pickles almost in trouble. And still not out of it because it's Calliope. Calliope to Ford, number 10. Oh, a great effort! And a beautiful save, saved by Standard. Well, that's why Ford is such a dangerous player, and Jim Standard, often underrated by the West Ham fans, but two great saves he's made in the last few minutes. Pugh to take the corner for Sheffield Wednesday. Here's Eustace for Wednesday. Says the referee. Goal kick. Calliope looking round as if to claim that he'd been obstructed. Mobley to Young. Fuel to four. Got nine men back in defence. He didn't get the breakthrough. That ball has been over the line. It's a goal kick. To Hurst. As Peters up alongside Hurst. Sissons. Red Rook and a goal! Here the scorer, number 9, there he is. Now if watch this goal again, and this is the vital moment. This centre from the left wing, it's a centre which is misjudged because it's a cleverly flighted centre with height and pace way to the far corner. It seems to hang in midair, and this is what upsets Megson. That's the defender going up now much too soon. There's Braybrook, and with the defence on the wrong foot, Deere is able to come in with that right foot and West Ham take the lead 1-0. So now Wednesday are going to have to find their shooting boots. Throw and the corner to Sheffield Wednesday. Now trail 1-0. Up into the penalty area goes the tall Vic Mobley. Number 4 and Young. And it's Pugh with the corner. Gwynn. Oh, that was a. The crowd going, no wonder, and I think my heart stopped too. The referee blown for a foul. Good job, Bobby Moore had heard it. Eustace Ford. Oh, standing. Almost caught out that it's a foul by. The referee has given a free kick. Penalising Quinn, but was giving full marks for the way he nipped in so smartly.
So it's
a free kick to West Ham United. Peters coming away for West Ham. For Wednesday. We have another go. Pugh alongside him. Here's Pugh. This is Young and Metzen going down the left. No, that wasn't hands. And Braybrook. Just caught off balance. Boosters. Quinn. There's Charles up. Did he tackle him too late? Or did he not? I don't think he did. It's offside. Offside anyway. Charles played very well indeed, but I hope that's not a recurrence of his old injury. Charles has been off for a few matches because of injury. He's not looking too happy at the moment, and he is going off for attention. That's a bad old scrum, isn't it? Charles off the field. Interesting to find out whether he's going to stay off or whether he's just going to have the muscles strapped up. No, he's going off altogether. So Trevor Dawkins will come on for West Ham. He's now Pugh for Sheffield Wednesday. Substitute isn't on yet. Now Ford trying to harass Pickles. And now it's Justus. More chance for Wednesday. And it's Seeley back there to give away a corner. At the moment, West Ham playing with 10 men. P Pugh to take the corner for Sheffield Wednesday. Oh, beautifully taken by Standard. Away comes Braybrook now. Pugh after him. Jumping into Young. Free kick to Sheffield Wednesday. Wednesday, of course, what a strike of West Ham with 10 men. A Pugh. That's badly for him. And the 12th man now is coming on, the substitute coming on. There's Dawkins, number 12. Dawkins, who's on the transfer list, he's a midfield player, he's rather worried that such a wealth of talent at West Ham, so he can't get a chance. And here he is in action straight away, Dawkins, and catches dear offside. Sending the substitute off because yes, there's Dawkins. Well, he's not played in the first team this season. He came on quarter of an hour from the end, and now mysteriously he's been sent off. And I think the referee is not allowing a substitute. Well, now this is interesting. I think the referee is claiming that he didn't beckon the substitute on, so he can stay off until he is beckoned on. Rather be sent off again if West Ham can get penalties. And there is Trevor Dawkins, and it's Hurst going to take the penalty. Hurst, number 10, versus Springett.
Now, some people doubted that penalty decision, so let's have a look at it again. There's Sidden's magnificent body swerve, the quick acceleration. Now watch Young when he comes into tackle in this penalty area. There's the tackle. Does he take the ball or the man? That's the decision you'd have had to have made in quick time if you've been the referee.
The West Ham lead 2-0 and look as if they're set for their first victory of 1967. Dawkins to Sissons. Dear, Braybrook calling for a square one. And he's got it. Sealing. Braybrook to Bovington. Dawkins, who operated midfield. Dawkins. levels. Crowd wanted a shot then. Hurst. Silly appeal for offside. No play on, says the referee and linesman, but now it's a goal kick. Given the offside, free kick to Wednesday. Calliope to Quinn. Granfoot. Can anyone climb up to that? Jim Standard can. Up to Braybrook. The referee has spotted that bit of pulling. We get to West Ham. First to Sissons. Green! That's the way to pop them in, young John Sissons. What an example of first-time shooting that was. Let's have a look at Sissons in action again. There's Hurst sending him through, and Sissons, even when he's challenged, wastes no time at all, and in slow motion it still looks to be going like a bullet, doesn't it? 3-0.
This is now something like the old West Ham, isn't it? Sheffield Wednesday. Catching a packet now, 3-0 down. And up now comes Moore. Sissons. To Deer. Down, and Ellis, the man who did the chopping. Amazing what a goal does to West Ham United. Three goals in 18 minutes they've got, after struggling for over an hour without one. And they got four. Peters.
No.
And there's McCallion going down the right. Five minutes left for play. Oh, what a silly one by Moore. Almost giving Wednesday a goal. There's Moore, but he rarely does a thing like that. With 5 minutes left, three goals in the lead, West Ham quite happy. And the crowd behind the goal to our left really happy with the way the game's gone. McCallion for Wednesday. To Mobley.
they want to take it, been deflected. Now Sissons for West Ham. There's Peters on the left. Wednesday, forward to Ellis. Hurst to Braybrook. Braybrook out to Dawkins. Arlington with the throw. Dawkins to Peters. Sissons. There's Ellis. And it's offside against Hurst. Free kick to Wednesday. It's almost over now. West Ham. 2 points to the good. Well, not many shots have gone in at the West Ham goal. That was a good one. Foul. It's far by Beckles on Quinn. Free kick to Sheffield Wednesday. Young to take the free kick. He's going to have a crack. Or is he going to just chip it forward? Now Peter's coming clear for West Ham. Oh, Springer taking a leap out of Standen's book. Did the same thing earlier on in the game. Max living it for Ford. The whistle going any second now. In fact, it goes now with West Ham United the winners by 3-0.
The price of that victory is that John Charles, who's just come back into the side after a muscle injury, has injured the same muscle again. It's not thought to be very serious, though, thankfully. Now, we welcomed back to football today after suspension two stars, Maurice Setters of Stoke City, who was in trouble again. He was booked in a fiery match at Sheffield United, in which there was trouble in the crowd, and three spectators taken to hospital. The second star who came back was Nobby Stiles of Manchester United, and he put through his own goal in the last minute of the Manchester Derby at Main Road, and so Manchester United, before the day's biggest crowd of 63,000, dropped a valuable point. Valuable because Liverpool won and have now got a one-point lead at the top of the First Division. Nottingham Forest also dropped a point, but these three are now drawing well clear of the rest of the field. The almost doomed Brentford had their biggest crowd of the season, 10,670 people today, and it is said that some of them were Queen's Park Rangers fans going to have a look at their new ground. Now, next week, Match of the Day will be concentrating on the FA Cup. So I hope you'll join us then. Till then, good night.